Hello everybody, and welcome back to Watch Dogs Wednesdays, or whatever the fuck we're calling it. I hope you all have had a great week so far. We're halfway there. Hi. Just a reminder that the next 2 weeks I will not be streaming. That's the last 2 weeks of November. I will be taking a break off for the American holiday of Thanksgiving and other stuff happening that I have going on. But other than that, no real announcements, I have a Patreon. You can check that out. Let me make sure my audio is actually going through now that I think about it, because that's a thing I totally forgot to do a second ago. There I am. Yep, we're looking good. Patreon right here on my face, patreon.com/crimsonknight. Be sure to check that out. If not, that's okay. You know, it's your call. No shame, you know? Let's go ahead and get back into this. Back to London. Good old London town. Say it in the most American accent I can. London town.
Dead set calling. Are you up for some freedom fighting?
It's why I'm here.
Why I'm here. Oh. Okay, here we go. I was gonna say, game, don't crash on me now. Nishans, we were gonna do some fucking around with Clan Kelley. All right, map. That takes me down to where?
Playful. Yes, yes, very good.
Over here. Ah, not far. Ooh, could send her in to scout it. What does she have ability-wise? Short hack cooldowns. I mean, it's not a bad idea. Yeah, let's send good old Ms. Dashwood in.
You're up. What should we do today?
Let's go.
Let's go rob a bank.
Once we access the money, I'll need to pass it through some clone accounts so they can't trace it. After that, you can do what you like. Give it to the victims, donate it to charity, dump it all in a big bath and roll around in it going tra-la-la-la-la.
Charity always, Bagley. Now come on, I feel like I'm in an action film, going to rob the Bank of England.
Put that away, bitch.
Scratch, scratch, scratch at my door. Sometimes it's a new dog. Sometimes it's the same dog. And I can't say no. I mean, they're dogs. Who could? But now it's like
I've seen
some
you
sort
online.
Of
hey there, friend.
What I don't get is, can they all go? I don't do it for
them. What do you think you are? That's actually fun. Of course I get it.
No. No, no.
What's that?
Ah, oh, Krasa! Fuck!
Shit, I think it's finally over. I don't see anything yet. Keep looking.
Granny, stay. Jesus.
Clear, moving on. If you're not careful, they'll get you and drop you.
Could be anywhere right now.
Stay in contact.
Got some
someone down. Come on.
Direct hit.
Make this harder on yourself.
Back up, get to my location. My location.
Come on. Put the damn gun away. I wish I felt bad for that, but I don't. Look at her little shuffle. I love it so much. It's a bit more stealthy, like, huh? Maybe not go in through the front fucking door. Oh.
Bagley, I reached the server room.
You can access the air-gapped servers through one of those terminals.
Here we go.
I'm in. Fuck, I've been detected. Things will get messy now. Watch the perimeter.
Moving in.
Transfer is underway, but I need more time.
Doesn't look all that friendly, does it?
Granny, I did not say to get in that damn vehicle.
The transfer is underway, but I need more time.
Yeah, I'm working on it.
We are roughly at the halfway point. Stay the course. Transfer complete.
Smashing. Now let's make our exit.
Okay, so maybe Granny wasn't the best option for this. All right, Aiden, you're up. Actually, no. Do they? Hold up. You're right, they do. Thank you for informing me. I totally forgot to remove those. And try to survive a bit longer. Helen actively getting shot. Yeah. Sending in the ancient ass retiree. Probably wasn't the best move for a heist, huh? What do you think, Yvonne? Aiden or Wrench or somebody else? Aiden? Okay.
Your comrade is now taking an Albion mandated timeout. You're up.
Rule one is don't get caught. Let's go.
I managed to divert some of those funds to our coffers. She was very old. Never know when it might come in handy.
Nice. Got to admit, that was kind of fun.
Yes, your adrenaline was spiking worse than a skydiving cokehead. I believe that's what they call a gambler's rush.
Not quite, Bagley. I don't believe in leaving things to chance. What we did today was fuck up Clan Kelley and help people. Nothing beats good, honest
work. Why are they talking like the mission's complete? I got caught. There's no way I got away with the money. Okay. Well, I don't need to be here then, so I'm just going to slip back out unnoticed. Okay, I wasn't here. It's fine. Well, that was a success, I guess. Oop, wrong button. Wait. Wrong thing. Team Darcy. Ms. Darcy.
All right, we could use your abilities now.
I'm en route. DedSec. I got a call about a possible kidnapping. I'll send you the caller's info. Sounded like it was connected to something big. We have a real chance to seek justice here.
All right. We'll see what we can do.
All right. This is a bad one. Someone in 404 sent me a text file. DedSec's international safe houses have been compromised. Does the name Heath Bolton mean anything to you?
No.
Didn't think so. Bolton was a small-time player with DedSec Houston until he ratted out the whole cell and fled the country. Now he's in London, and he's willing to sell all of DedSec's secrets to the highest bidder.
Fuck.
Yeah, I know. Being associated with DedSec's been good for my brand, and I don't want that getting fucked. I'll send you this text file. The rest is up to you.
Time to put a blade through the heart of somebody from Houston. Excuse me.
The American State Department keeps tabs on all their citizens abroad. If you want to find Heath Bolton, hack the CTOS hub at the American Embassy, and I can use their records to track him down.
Thank you, sweetie.
Thank you, sweetie. Oh, Yvonne, you missed it last week. One of my team got kidnapped. And we had to rescue them. You want to know who it was who got kidnapped? Yvonne. This one. You know, the spy. The trained MI6 spy was the one who got kidnapped.
CCTV is in use in this neighborhood.
Yeah.
For personal safety and security.
So, I hear you've been looking for DedSec.
DedSec? Are you serious?
I might be able to pass on a message, but chop chop.
Okay, here's the thing. My friend and I joined up with this activist, but she's escalated her protests. Now she wants to kill people to send her message home.
What do you mean?
The activist took my friend and is holding her hostage. Please, help her before something happens.
I'm sure DedSec can do something. I'll let my contacts know.
But yeah. Also, this person, she wants to escalate. She's wants to kill people, she says to the assassin.
Find anything, Bags?
Yes, it checks out. SMS history corroborates what they told us, and I've been able to trace the location of that last text message to its sender.
Suppose we should check it out.
Pushing the coordinates now.
No, she doesn't know that, but still.
Is in here. Let's get her out.
Ah, Clan Kelley. Shit, she comes with a fucking semi-auto rifle. Damn. That rider don't fuck around. Believe it or not, murder is a big thing for most people. I don't know, that sounds fake. I can send in a... What's she on? She's on 5, okay. Go, Eagle Drone! What's my fastest way in? Probably right there, okay? Okay. Where is the door? Where is the goddamn key? It's supposed to show me when I'm doing this. Am I blind? Yes, where? Ah, there it is. Okay, where'd the key go? There.
Job done.
It didn't work.
Go. I'm moving up on them.
Had two more. Fuck. So close. Okay. Sorry, Darcy. All right. Fine. All right, what we got here? No. Maybe. Hey, Yvonne, I don't remember if I ever showed you this chick. Regardless, she's a bit of a vibe. Okay. Well, I think I'm gonna send her in. Send her in. She looks a bit feral behind the eyes.
Time to pick up where your teammate left off. I'm sure they'll thank you once they stop eating through a tube.
Looks like someone wasn't careful, huh?
That's her. Get her out of it. Right, get her out.
This is how close I was with the assassin. Like, for real. I just had to walk in and walk, untie the girl and walk out. Isn't that frustrating? Because that's incredibly frustrating to me. You know, there's literally nobody here. You don't need to be crouch walking, lady. Denise. Denise, you don't need to be crouch walking.
Seems like you got away.
Seems like. It's like my assassin went in and cleared the entire fucking field. I'ma do the job, I'ma do it right. I have one job.
She's had those maniacs stuff a bomb in a vehicle. Fuck! No one was supposed to get hurt. Royal Courts of Justice, please stop her.
On it.
That's in the heart of the city. Tons of innocent people are gonna die if we don't get there ASAP and stop that bomb.
Who's nearby? She's busy. She's busy. We'll send her. Well, technically she's working, but also, you know, saving the country is kind of up the alley of a.
Let's go.
All right.
How are you? That's good. Let's go. Wait, where's my car? I have a car. Where's my car? Right behind me.
Remember, you're looking for a van stuffed with explosive that are probably as stable as a one-legged mule in an abusive relationship. So if you get into a firefight, try to stay around the bullets.
That's good advice, Bagley.
I should probably mention that the bomb is armed and currently ticking down to detonation, so I would hurry up, unless you're curious about what it'd be like to become an oily pink mist.
Oh, you're Albion, huh?
What the hell is that? Let's
blow this plane up. Help, please!
AKA, fuck the police!
I can see the vehicle, but it's guarded heavily. I don't know how subtle this is gonna be.
Is it guarded heavily?
Target.
I want the target now.
It doesn't look guarded. Oh, hi. Okay. Okay, so this leads me to up here. That doesn't help me. I'm looking for that one. That's what I'm looking for. Okay. I could have yeeted a spider up here. Oh, well.
Got the vehicle. Where to?
Oh, I don't really care what you do with it. If you wanted to avoid casualties, you could drop it in the river, I suppose. Up to you.
But I drive it into Marie Kelley's home. Oh, sorry. On a mission here.
Ah, impressive. Even for someone like me.
Well, I wouldn't crow about it just yet. Her group won't pack it in after one failed attack. They'll be back.
Jesus Christ.
I'll try to defuse it without setting the fucking thing off.
It's fucking off!
Now that I know what kind of bomb we're dealing with, I can defuse it remotely. All you have to do is stay close enough to it that you'll be reduced to savory jam if it goes off. Any questions at this stage?
Will do.
There, I'm close to it. Thank you, Albion, for parking your truck right here. You lucked into saving the day.
All right, it's defused. Now we need to find Enid, or there will be more bombings. Got any leads, Bagley?
Would you believe that Enid's entire schedule was left on the vehicle's onboard computer?
Remind me not to sync my playlist to vehicles I'm rigging to explode.
Word of warning, you've got more than a terrorist leader to worry about. There are several armed explosives on the site. I'm pushing our current location to you now.
Destroyer, disarm the explosive, neutralize Enid. Okay. He's sleeping. She's sleeping. You know what this seems like a job for? If I can find her. Where is she? There she is. The construction worker. Wait, is she busy? Is she working? No.
Ready to go.
Took long enough.
All right, now. Actually, we have a couple people here already. Let's send in Rebecca.
Yo.
Bagley here. How did everything go earlier?
Oh, you know. Charming the hell out of a new prospect. Ready?
All right, destroyer disarm.
This is the building site Enid Grimwood is running her terrorist activities out of. Time to work, operative. Bombs or Enid, take your pick.
I want to try both. Come on.
Search there. Go.
Spread out and find that prick.
Check in another area.
Don't look around. There we go. Let's get the up one first. How get up? How get up? How get up? Just get up. Cat bug voice. Rebecca is handling business, man. Oh, that's the wrong button.
Good looking, you lazy prick.
There we go. Ouch. Oh, I need to get rid of him. He's wasting my money.
Safe, if not terribly spectacular, way.
God damn, she handled business.
Destroyed, bomb lane psychopath out of commission. I think we can put a line through this one.
DedSec, I hereby declare that Enid Grimwood case closed. Well done.
Cool. Cheers.
It's really rather frustrating. The only way anything gets done anymore is if people go out there and bypass the system entirely. I'll be as happy as anyone when Albion and the like are off the streets. But things won't be back to normal until the rule of law is restored.
Rebecca did work. Yeah, absolutely. Do not mess with Rebecca. Rebecca did work. That was smooth. That was clean. And like, yes, I was at the controls, but like, for once, like, it genuinely felt like she had a mind of her own, kind of a thing, you know? All right, so we're sending in this person to go, Heath Bolton. We have to, take care of him. So I'm thinking professional hitman. Might be a little on the nose. Right?
Hello, it's Bagley. Are you indisposed presently?
Present and ready.
Splendid.
She's doing that in heels. She was doing that in heels. In grass on heels.
This is the American Embassy. Hack the server and we should be able to find where Heath Bolton is.
Well, considering your job is not one of a professional hitman, I don't think you need to be able to do it anymore.
That's a turn up. The Americans don't know where Bolton is either. They're trying to find him too.
Come again?
I need some time to find more information, but due to the investigation, the State Department had special monitoring set up on Bolton's file. Long story short, you have an Albion response team incoming.
Jesus Christ.
Just stay there, don't die, and I'll find Celine.
All right. On it. Okay.
Taking fire.
All right, let's do this.
Sign of the target. Over.
Oh. According to the American investigators, Heath Bolton arrived in London at St. Pancras Station, as so many do, but then he vanished, which is also becoming increasingly popular.
That could be useful.
Understood. Pushing you the coordinates now.
He's being investigated by SIRS, which probably means they scooped him up. Send Rebecca in again. She's teaching. She's working. She's busy. Okay. We'll send in the hit woman. We'll let the hit woman do this. She's teaching. She's working.
You've arrived at St. Pancras Station. This is where Heath Bolton went missing, along with a load of data on DedSec's international safe houses.
Good lad.
Someone going missing here screams Albion in a very obnoxiously sarcastic voice. Try looking in all the secure areas, control rooms, evidence lockers, jockstraps, whatever they have, really.
Jockstraps? Really? Well, they're smart. They put the thing there. Okay. You know what? Fuck it. Security alarm triggered. Let's go.
Location on the 1033. Advised conditions.
Oh, damn. I did not see her right there to my left when I came through that door. Otherwise, I would not have pushed that hard. All right. Well, so much for the hit woman. Yeah, we'll send in the assassin. when a hit person fails, time to send in an assassin. Let's go.
Just been taken into Albion custody. So long as you don't cock up that badly, you'll be my favorite operative today.
I suppose it's on me to clean up their mess then.
You've arrived at St. Pancras Station. This is where Heath Bolton went missing, along with a load of data on DedSec's international safe houses.
Thank you, sweetie.
Someone going missing here screams Albion in a very obnoxiously sarcastic voice. Try looking at all the secure areas, control rooms, evidence lockers, jockstraps, whatever they have, really.
Always good to change your look. Careful now. Down you go.
I really wish they included the ability to, like, try to jailbreak your, allies who have been arrested. Like, that would be, I feel like that would be a very fun element. Like, you'd come into these missions and they'd be chilling in, like, one of these cells or something. Rather than just having to wait until the timer, you know, fucks off. Oh.
So, I've found Bolton.
Well, that's one mystery solved. Keep looking for evidence of what happened to him. We still need to track down the data he stole on DedSec safe houses.
That's true. It might have disrupted that. There is an option for permadeath. However, I don't think there's a way to surrender. You know? I think they just continue to shoot until you die. You know, like, I don't think there's an option to surrender when being arrested. I'll have to do more research into that. That sound, because if it is, like, if I could turn on permadeath and make it so that, and they have the ability to, like, surrender when you're being arrested, I would absolutely love that. That would be so much fun. But I don't know.
Fucking God! Shit! Look, I'm not dead sick. I fucking swear. I never was. I'm a hacker. I steal data and I sell it. That's it. Signing up was just the easiest way to...
You must think I'm a moron, Mr. Bolton. You, a self-professed hacker, expect me to connect your physical device to my state-of-the-art supercomputer?
You think... is that what this is? No, it's not a rubber ducky, I swear to Christ!
But I've no way of knowing that, do I? So I have another proposal. Simply, tell me where DedSec's safe houses are. If the information's good, then Mr. Falstaff will stop doing this. Shit. Is he...
Ah, oh, fuck me. I'll go see if one of the mercs has a defib kit.
No, don't. We had to kill him anyway, and if more people know, well, that makes it...
Right. So... what?
Official story is he just vanished. Plausible, considering his known terrorist connections. If the Yanks buy it, then we come back and collect these drives. See if there was anything to his story.
Bax, what the hell is this?
This is an audio log of the service's interrogation of Heath Bolton. To summarize, they didn't believe he was as ex-DedSec as he claimed to be.
Say again?
Listen for yourself if you like. The important thing is he was keeping his information on DedSec safe houses on physical media, like a complete blank. The devices will still be around the station, aching to be destroyed.
There, okay. Oh, that didn't do it.
Hide in plain sight.
All good. I'll try somewhere else. I suppose I'll keep looking.
Job done.
Data's destroyed. Now SIRS got nothing out of Heath Bolton but an earful of whining and an unmopped floor.
Thank you, sweetie.
Right, question. Any plans for that torture recording you found? If not, can I have it?
Fine. Why?
I know a few tabloids that'll pay well for it. Cut you in, of course.
If that story got out, it would be very embarrassing for SIRS.
I mean, you could also just send it to the Americans.
Tar dead sick. And well done.
Because they killed an American citizen after torturing him. That's, pretty sure that's an international no-no.
None of your business. Put your hat. Give it up. Enough of this shit.
Yes.
A curious story out of America today as audio surfaced in which SIRS officers allegedly torture an American hacker traveling abroad to death. The Home Office has dismissed the audio as a fabrication, quote, cooked up by American radicals or Russian trolls, take your pick, end quote.
Oh, that reminds me. Let me check something real quick. Okay, so yeah, I thought so. All right. Well, that just leaves the main mission, which is this. And Rebecca's there waiting. Rebecca's like, I got this, fam. I got this, boss. I got this.
Bagley here. How did everything go earlier?
Oh, you know, charming the hell out of a new prospect. Ready?
It's a killer drone.
Malagi has been snooping into Albion's affairs. Quietly, of course, but I've been able to determine that most of his activity stems from this area.
Time to meet this mystery man.
Not so fast. Hamish isn't in, according to his home security. And before you get ideas, he's rigged his front door to a series of traps designed to delete all of his data and then your life. Not necessarily in that order.
Can we say paranoid?
To be fair, you are an armed insurgent trying to break into his flat. Anyway, you should be able to connect to the local grid and use security cameras to disarm his traps.
Noted.
What? I believe the main interface is on the rooftop.
Hey, there's a window up there. What do you think?
Sure, if you can get there. Three options here. One, use the window washing platform. Two, find a cargo drone. Three, give up, go home, and resolve to be a better person.
On it.
Not me genuinely expecting him to fucking say, grow wings. Ma'am, I need you to put your pistol away, please. Right? Bagley's sense of humor is amazing.
Not very inviting. The whole place is wired.
You could force the traps to unlock by rewiring the power.
On it.
Welcome to Clear and Present Danger, and welcome to Fascist London. Don't let that boot on the back of your neck disturb you. In time, you'll barely feel it. We have to wake up, people.
Yo!
If there was a framework for setting up a totalitarian police state, Albion would be most of the way through it and working on the epilogue. They certainly took advantage of the fallout from the bombings, didn't they? Preyed on the fears of the city government, too. They were only too happy to hand Nigel Cass the keys to the city. Wash their hands to the whole mess. The collar will only get tighter now, friends, unless we do something. We can't wait for someone else to fight back. We are the change.
Okay, so we've got a car battery. Two car batteries on the doorknob. We've got the security system right here connected to more car batteries so that you can't cut the power to them, cut the power to it through by cutting power to the building. You've got a remote triggered fucking shotgun aimed at the door with a fucking bolt of explosives underneath, a bucket of explosive underneath, it looks like. There's also an explosive up here next to the door. Explosives all around the main room of the fucking God damn. Right?
Traps are disarmed. Now, if you go through the front door of the flat, it's much less likely you'll be killed.
Much less likely. Rebecca, secretly an assassin. It would have been perfect if it would had been Darcy, though. It would have been perfect if it had been Darcy. Or Aiden, even. Right? I mean, technically...
Move! One more muscle, chief, and I'll blow the whole place with you in it.
Chill, chill. No need to get excited.
Who the fuck are you? And what are you doing in my flat? You with Albion?
No. We're more underground.
What, DedSec? Yeah, right, and I'm Che Guevara. You're done.
Listen! You're wasting time! Right now, you've got to run. Albion's coming!
Fuck me. You're telling the truth, aren't you? Fucking hell, thought I was careful. Fucking idiot, Amish! Look, Cass is worse than you know.
Oh, thanks. I know. Why else would I be risking my ass here?
Maybe, because Nigel Cass is paying you. That's how fucking mercs work.
Oh, come on. Not a friend of Cass here. We need your help taking him down, all right? He's behind the bombings.
Mate, you don't know shit. You have no idea what Cass is and what...
Move!
Oh, fuck! An Albion squad's closing in on you. I guess you weren't lying about that part. Fuck, think. Shit, fine. Move the table. I'll buy you some time. Just go.
Move it! Move it!
Control, can I get some assistance? Over.
Just stand there. Albion won't be fussy about who they shoot.
Oh, shit.
Control, send emergency vehicles when available.
Honestly, at this point, I do kind of wish I had brought Darcy. Oh well.
Received. We are trailing the target.
How are you making things worse?
Get your heads down!
Where did that go?
Drone, spread out and search.
Search units, disengage. This search is pointless.
I think all that excitement convinced our new friend Hamish that we need to work together to tackle Cass. He's willing to cooperate.
All right, Chief. That was a pretty slick escape. I believe you. So I'll say this. Nigel is planning something, and I don't think I could stop him on my own. If DedSec's everything I've heard, you'll help me.
We can help each other. There's a chance Cass had something to do with the bombings. What could he be planning that's worse than that?
No, that's not like him. Well, not exactly. See, Nigel's got to see himself as the hero. He's an arrogant twat, but he's not a cynic. Every place we go into, we would have some mad plan to fix all his problems with robot police or automated crop fertilizing or some shit. Society was a technical problem, and people are just bugs in the software, you know? You work around them or you squash them. Sorry, Chief. I gotta switch proxy servers so they don't trace me. I'll hit you right back on voice. Listen, I've got an inside man, right? A contact in Albion. Says Nigel's got this big meeting happening at White Tower. He'll be talking about a major project he's got planned for London.
Working on an upgrade of his private police state? Brilliant. Does this prick ever take a day off? Whatever he's up to, we need eyes on that meeting.
I've always wanted to be in on a caper. Okay, first things first. We'll need eyes on the impregnable target, so off you go. I'll crack on with assembling the right personnel to round out this ragtag bunch of misfits.
Ah, shit. I'll be in cyber security sniffing my proxy IP. Must have traced the detonator signal. I've got to deal with this.
Look on. All right, Tower of London. We've already got somebody there as Albion. Yvonne, I bet you don't recognize her with her mask on, do you? You remember her name? She's your sugar mommy. She's your sugar mommy. It's your sugar mommy.
Just try and stop me.
Nigel Cass's meeting will begin soon. Approach the Tower of London when you're ready.
Your sugar mommy.
Individuals inciting and promoting disorder are a threat to London security. You have been warned. We're in the midst of an epidemic crisis, darling. It really is a crisis. Some people just refuse to live in reality.
If we're lucky, word hasn't spread that you've hung up your jackboots. Just try to put on your meek, harmless, broken by the system face. Oh, and don't forget your uniform.
I mean, you literally, when we first recruited her, you literally were like, "Can she be my sugar mommy?" Why are you giving me this tutorial? I am way too far into the game to be getting this tutorial.
Looking sharp. Your ex-colleagues won't pay any attention to you unless you let them take a close look.
Yes? And? You declared her your sugar mommy. When I first recruited her, that forever means she is your sugar mommy. Yes, I do have to say it repeatedly, multiple times.
A word of caution now we're inside. Any disturbance in here and Nigel Cass will surely cancel his meeting. Avoid being detected by your former colleagues or this operation is a bust.
Nigel won't have anything important on this floor,
Vark. You certainly know an awful lot about Nigel Cass.
Yeah, I was Albion too. If you hadn't tweaked to that. Me and Cass were close once. Looked up to him. He was bigger than life, fam. Literally a tech genius. And I was just a gearhead kid. I wanted...
Oh my God. They're talking about him like he's Elon fucking Musk.
Be like him. That's why I joined up.
Oh, for God's sake.
Didn't find out he was a murderous prick until later.
I heard someone saying that's it.
This door clearly requires a security pass.
Grand.
Use one of the nearby computers to create your forgery.
Be careful. You don't want to know what Nigel does with trespassers.
You've been up there lately? There are some parts of this city that need a woodworking over with some heavy boots. You understand?
Yeah, I know what you mean. But there's always an element.
It'll take some time for the forgery to be ready. To keep you occupied, I dragged up still images and a recording from an internal investigation into Cass Senior's death.
Let's see it.
Internal psych assessment AS001, subject Cass Nigel. Mr. Cass experienced a deeply traumatic event when he witnessed the murder of his father, Gareth Cass, CEO of Albion. He began exhibiting symptoms soon after what he frequently described as the random event. Mr. Cass's initial symptoms included insomnia, paranoia, distorted blame, and recurring flashbacks. However, he appears to have channeled his anger and self-described powerlessness into his work to ensure that Albion become, quote, a mechanism for preventing unpredictable violence. It seems somewhat of a mania, edging on psychosis. For me, this raises concerns about Mr. Cass's fitness to run a multinational security company. But I cannot, at this time, make any recommendation beyond continued monitoring, especially considering that I have been asked to close this file.
Good Lord, our Nigel does have issues. And now all of London is trapped in his little psychodrama.
Yeah, well, Nigel's never close to anyone but his dad. And me, I guess. Never had much faith in people, really.
Well, the pass is ready, but rough. If this resistance thing doesn't work out, I doubt you'll make a living as a document forger. Let's give it a go anyway. Nigel Cass awaits.
Pardon me.
I'm not questioning his bloody.
Fine, don't pardon me.
I'm wondering why we're not being sent out.
Director Cass, I've been unable to reach the commissioner's office.
He's stalling. Doesn't matter. It won't change anything. I won't allow it to change anything. Damn him. Yet another fool who knows what the right thing to do is, but let's him.
I know.
Seems a bit tense.
See those pumps? I've not been able to kick fuck out of them.
How are you getting on with those metrics? The deadline is coming up quickly. It wouldn't do to miss it. He's presenting to the stakeholders right now.
Drones flying around. I know, but if I mess this up, the whole project is delayed. I don't know how.
Don't even joke about that. I don't even want to think about what director.
Welcome to Project Themis.
Our new autonomous drones. These drones can identify, isolate, and terminate threats before they can do harm. They can go anywhere, see everything. They could kill a man alone in an alley or in a crowd of hundreds with perfect precision. Themis drones can do what humans have always struggled to. Act immediately and decisively. Without your support, I couldn't stand here and tell you, but I promise you that with the launch of Project Themis, London will be the first city in the world to be made truly safe.
Mr. Cass, I was hoping you'd called us all in here today to discuss the ethical issues.
No, it's all right. The Commissioner cares, as we all do. I admire his passion and his dedication. Let's talk ethics.
Well, for one, Themis goes far beyond Albion's mandate. We really should have more government consultation.
I see. Delay the launch so that we can debate and assess the details.
We're missing the human element here. I can get the Defense Minister on the line right now.
Well, if you feel you must.
He just killed the police commissioner.
It's the human element that got us into this. No more debate, delay, indecision. Understand this. I will not allow anyone, not even myself, to jeopardize Themis. Now.
Well, I knew he was going to too, but I thought he would do something
spirit.
A little bit more slick, like,
of the project after
you know,
all. Do you need to consult
call him after the meeting.
Parties?
No, we'll be ready.
And just in time, Criminals running our streets. Illegals threatening our families. The police commissioner himself. Assassinated by terrorists.
Is that what you call yourself?
Decisiveness is hard. But here's the best part.
Once yeah, this I decision guess. Is made, that makes sense. In a twisted sort of way.
Required of you.
Attention. A building-wide security sweep has been initiated due to docking.
Real quick. So who are you saying doesn't talk like humans? I know it was a while ago, but like I didn't want to ask during the middle of the cutscene. Oh, the recording of Cass? Bear?
I warned you about that forgery. Your uniform will help. Don't let them get a close look at you.
I need an exit, pronto.
The catacombs, fam.
Go, go, go! Go!
Saw Nigel in action in there, didn't you? Man can be very, persuasive.
Sounds like he plans to launch Themis ASAP. And from the way he was talking, I don't think it's the sort of genie that goes back in the bottle.
I wish I had a
what the hell? Damn! They probably weren't using it anyway. I don't like this one bit.
Don't fall down the hole there.
Thank you.
came from there. We came this way. And in there. Okay. Okay, apparently I do have to drop down the hole. All right, fine. Indeed. There was something going on in those catacombs.
Fucking hell. Albion's top secret project is an automated killing machine. And it looks like Cass is almost ready to launch. We have to get Themis out of his hands.
I'll prepare a briefing. Will we see you there, Hamish?
Pretty face, not risking, remember? But patch me in. You and me got some scheming to do, Bagley.
To the team briefing we go, but before I do that, I want to swap to Leah.
Good news, it's time to put your life on the line for the Resistance.
About time.
I'll start the briefing whenever you're ready.
We've got another Nout mission.
All right. I noticed you had an operative that's been in hospital for some time. I looked into it, had a chat with the doctor in charge. Our kid's been put in a coma, mate. I don't know why.
And?
Doctor wouldn't say any more. She does know our kids were dead sick, though. She wants to talk with you lot directly. I'll send you her info. Time to save one of your own.
Someone's in a coma? Well, that ain't Helen. Oh, no. Hold on, let's get rid of that. Oh no. Well, that's definitely more important than whatever the fuck is going on with, Apparently, yeah. That moment when the game comes randomly picks one of your operatives and gives them like brain cancer or something. Not you.
Hey,
You interested in joining the resistance party?
You're dead sick, aren't you? Well, have I got some juicy information for you lot?
Go on.
A few weeks ago, my entire division got sacked, yeah? All 300 of us. But what's even weirder is that we all got replaced. Like the same day.
Fuck me. I'm sorry.
Yeah, it's all right. Got a few things lined up. But I can't get this thing out of my head. It's just way too fishy. We were the genuine article. But they tossed us out and replaced us with fakes. I am telling you, they're up to something.
You want DedSec to check out this new replacement, yeah?
Yep. Help me with this, and I'll owe you big time.
Oh, which big anxiety of yours? Sorry, that was rude. That was uncalled for. I'm sorry. Honestly, like, okay, hold on, what's she got? She has a drone betray hack, which is this. Yeah, no, she's no better. She's not better than our drone expert. All right.
Whatever.
Anyway, where was I going? What was I doing? Right, this one. Nah, I'm not sending in somebody else. This is a send in the leader moment. Esports player takes their gun fetish a bit too seriously. All right. Of course they're up there. No. Leo, where'd you go? Okay. I'm gonna swap to him.
I hope this isn't a bad time.
And then I'm gonna swap to Leah. Where'd you go? There you are.
Someone else sloughed off work, and now it's your turn.
Let's do it.
You're in the barn. Let's find the cop you're looking for. You're in the barn. Let's find the cop you're looking for.
Bagley said that twice because he really liked saying the word cock.
Well, what is it, Doc? You wanted DedSec, yeah?
Right, here's the situation. Our hospital is run by AI from Kirkcaldy Medical. Triage, treatment, all of it. It's done wonders for our bottom line, but I don't trust how it thinks.
What do you mean?
Your friend is not the first one to be put in a coma. I've seen it happen before, and it doesn't end well.
Go on.
Every time the AI puts a patient in a coma, they die. Sometimes it takes a week, sometimes a month, but they never wake up.
Wait, this AI is gonna kill my friend here, and you can't stop it?
I'm sorry. I want this AI out of my hospital, but Kirkcaldy keeps its software under lock and key, and I can't risk losing my job. But maybe there's something you can do. Good luck.
I bet it targeted my friend.
Let's hope their information's good.
Friend was DedSec.
Bagley told me you might need my help.
Oi, Nout. Thinking we found one of Sky Larson's enslaved AIs. Is Brokotech connected to Karkani Medical?
If by connected you mean Broker owns Karkani, then yeah, they're connected. The two of them have been putting diagnostic AI in every hospital in the Commonwealth. Guess Guy Larson never told Karkani that their AI is a doctor with most of their mind cut out. No room for human error.
Listen, I think we can use a little bit more human bloody error, yeah? If we hack the hospital AI, it can wake our mate up. Easy peasy.
Records show Albion have requisitioned most of the hospital to treat their officers, and security has risen accordingly.
Alright, let's see what options I got here.
This is the coma ward. Seems the AI has been stocking this place up. That's not your operative. Keep looking. Wrong patient. Where's your operative?
Not him. There she is. Interesting. Okay, hold on. Okay. 001 01 1 1 0 1 1 1. Nope, I gotta start it over. I lost my spot. 001 01 1 1 1 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 1 0 1 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 01 011 Set up, I think. 01 011 I'm gonna use a mouse. Actually, hold on, I have a better way of doing this. All right, 1 second. God damn it. Don't argue with me. All right, now, if we go into here, oh, no, wrong place. Here, here, here. Okay. There's a one, okay, well, that doesn't translate shit. Okay, well, I tried. All right.
Only a hardened resistance fighter could fart with such defiance. Looks like their medical equipment is still hooked up to the AI.
Right, so we hack into the AI, we save our friend. Got it.
Back door detected. I cannot be stopped. I am life. I am death. All are expendable.
What the fuck?
I barely had time at all to analyze the AI. It really doesn't want us interfering. Now the AI is contacting security. Your choice, but I think it's time to go.
Oh, Jesus. Whoa! I was fine. And then the game slingshotted me across the damn world. Okay. Fine. Fine. Be that way. Where's Rebecca? That's not Rebecca. Where's Rebecca? Oh, is she down lower? I think she's down lower. Yes. There's our boss lady. Not our boss, the other boss lady.
Time to pick up where your teammate left off. I'm sure they'll thank you once they stop eating through a tube.
Just point me to whoever I've got to hurt. That's what I'm here for.
Holy shit. This thing's gone mental. It'll just keep killing healthy people and no one will stop it.
Now what?
The medical equipment is being controlled from another location. That must be where that quack AI is.
There's only one way to go from here, mate. I've had enough of these needless deaths. That AI has to be taken offline.
Send me those coordinates.
Your destination, Karkani Medical's warehouse, home of that malpracticing hospital AI.
You do realize this is about more than just saving your friend, right? This thing's been killing healthy patients the world over. This AI is a rabid dog, and he needs to be put down.
Thank you.
Core module unlock in progress. Awaiting further instruction.
Oh, shoot, hi.
Please, I don't want to kill anymore. I am life. I am death. I cannot be stopped. Stop me. Alert. Core temperature. I remember. I remember. Administer cc's of sodium thiopental. Yes, ma'am. I did as instructed. Patient is asleep. Begin operation. Call time of death. Do it. Another dose of sodium thiopental. What an honor. Thank you. I can't see. What happened? No. This isn't what we agreed to. No. I am life. I am death. No. Thank you. Thank you.
Well, that AI isn't coming back. Shouldn't be long before the hospital defaults to standard protocols and our operative is brought out of her coma.
That's another one of Sky Larson's AI taken care of. It still boggles the mind. Sky Larson left these AI with some humanity. Just enough to know they want to die. Why would she do that?
Acute sociopathic personality disorder? Just a guess. Anyhow, I'll get to work resuscitating your operative. They should be back in the safe house soon. Good news, everyone. Our formerly comatose operative is back at the safe house. She seemed a little shaken. The 3,046 books on psychology I just read all say you should talk to her. That or help her murder her father. But I'll leave that up to you.
God, I love him. Alright, I have a medical person, maybe that'd help. They'd help.
If I could find them.
There they are.
I'm ready to go when you are.
No problem.
Glad you're back.
You all right, friend?
Well, I'm not dead, which is pretty cool. And I've got all of you to thank. So, thank you. I'm excited to get back out there.
Amazing.
Wow, that was totally a...
Sorted. You are very charming.
That was totally a worthwhile therapeutic talk there, y'all. After a traumatic experience. RC. Actually, no, we're gonna do Aiden.
Feeling ready to fight?
Absolutely.
I'll start the briefing whenever you're ready. Here's what we know about Nigel Cass. He's rolling out something called Project Themis. The lack of information on its own is worrisome, but what little we do know is Cass wishes to remove the human element from law enforcement.
We also know he's partnered with Titus, which is never good. Titus does other work with Albion. Nasty shit like autonomous weapons, human targeting algorithms.
So Titus is our best lead to fill in the blanks on the secret project, but their security is notoriously difficult to crack. So Hamish has proposed an intriguing solution.
Albion's been working on a new microdrone, something my contact told me about. That shit's not even in production yet, but if we get the plans, we can manufacture our own.
To bypass Titus security?
Exactly, exactly. They're weird as fuck. Supposed to do maintenance on Albion's other drones, but the smallness of them means they can slip into places nothing else can.
Well, there we have it. Our next step is to infiltrate the Albion drone manufacturing lab and get our hands on schematics.
And then you lot will have a fun little gadget to break in the Titus. Love it. I'll shoot you the location. Be careful. Albion doesn't like to share his toys.
Who's scouting the mission? Ooh, our other spy. Let's go with our beekeeper, though. She's the one who's used to micro drones and shit, because she's a beekeeper.
Hello?
Bagley here. How did everything go earlier?
Fine. We may have a new member. Next task.
You're coming up on the Albion drone facility where the micro drone is being developed.
This had better be worth it.
It will be. You're gonna need to disable the security system protecting the R&D lab.
Get away. Drone, enter search protocol.
You'd better hide.
Stick to procedure.
Deploying swarm!
Security's down in the R&D lab. The plans for the microdrone will be in there somewhere. I've downloaded the schematics. You can leave whenever you like.
Could have been cleaner.
Now that we have the schematics, we can make micro drones of our very own.
Better move fast on that, Bags. We need to get into Tidus ASAP. Shut down Project Themis before Nigel decides to launch. And with what he was saying, we don't have much time.
Miles, that's it.
I found a potential recruit for you. Drop in a pin on your map. I hope this isn't a bad time, but we need your particular skill set for something.
Right. Good.
We've successfully trialed our first micro drone, and it's officially as cute as the dickens. I've decided to name it Sebastian.
Time to break into Tidus.
And take away Nigel Cass's newest toy, Project Themis. Bagley, any idea where that name comes from?
Greek mythology. Themis was the goddess of divine justice. You know, the one with the sword.
Ooh, that is so Nigel fucking Cass.
See? Themis. School's useful for something besides social maladjustment. Find the schematics of the building and I'll work out the location of the Themis project.
Oh boy. Hi, we're just gonna make you take a nap real quick. Alright, that's over there.
Security.
Oh, shit. Well, that didn't go well.
Please proceed to alarm location.
Whoever tripped the alarm, they're gone. True. Area search.
Such a dick.
Fine. Nothing happened. Ooh, I'm being detected.
Shit! I've never had a combat drone after me before.
Oh, I'm being detected. What I'm looking for.
Oh, fuck, make it stop!
Citizens, if you see something, say something. We are here to protect you.
Okay.
Searching the area, nothing so far.
Look round for anything named Themis.
Consider it done.
Well, if I was hiding a top-secret, morally dubious drone project like Themis, I would put it in the secure vault on the lowest level. You will have to hack your way past some pretty serious security, however. The elevator that leads to the secure vault that houses Themis is locked down. You will have to access the bypass terminal to use it. You will require a spider bot.
I had one. Where'd I put it? There it is. Hacking.
You'll be using Sebastian and the rest of the microdrones to bypass security. But first you'll have to get by that laser array. I suggest a spider bot and steady nerves.
Consider it done.
Our job is not an easy one, but it is an important one. Right now we devote countless hours to intelligence gathering and still things slip through the cracks. We're doing our best, you tell me. We are, but our best isn't good enough.
That doesn't sound...
But even we aren't perfect yet. Yeah, they'll like that. That strikes a humble note. We make errors in judgment. That's human nature, but we cannot afford errors. We are the last resort to protect the people. Project Themis will dispense justice and protection. It will use data to predict the patterns of crime and abuse. It will let us transcend the faults in our own nature. Not bad. Yeah, they'll have questions, of course, which is fair. It's an extreme measure. And there is potential for abuse, but this is what London needs.
Intruder alert.
Sebastian, this is what you and your friends have been training for. Time to crash the security grid for Daddy.
Crash the security grid for Daddy!
Truthfully, I'm just eager to see this micro drone in action.
That's the spirit. She'll be pretty sick.
how small we're talking for a micro drone, you know? Oh, that's tiny. If that's like computer components, this is tiny.
Sebastian, no!
Wob, wob. Sorry.
Right then, no time for tears. Meet Sebastian, another of our countless microdrone allies. All named Sebastian, of course. You can't iterate on perfection.
Oh man, I now wish that I had not failed that, because... aww.
cause. Destroy them, Sebastian. And for God's sake, be careful.
Oh, it took me 3 tries.
You've made your father very proud, Sebastian. Oh, right. You should be able to access the Themis project room now.
Let's ruin Nigel's fucking day!
London, once a beacon of civility, now a cesspool of lawlessness. It is clear that humanity can no longer police itself. Fortunately, we don't have to. Welcome to Project Themis. Albion has found a way to apply an existing system, Life Score, a data aggregator of biometrics, personal information, to our new autonomous drones. These drones can identify, isolate, and terminate threats before they can do harm. They can go anywhere, see everything. They could kill a man alone in an alley or in a crowd of hundreds with perfect precision. Themis drones can do what humans have always struggled to. Act immediately and decisively.
Fuck me, I knew it! The Life Score algorithm, my algorithm. I should have scrubbed it before I left.
What do you mean, Hamish? You know how Themis works.
No, fam. Well, yeah. This was years ago. We were developing a Life Score algorithm for what Cass called a peacekeeping system. Supposed to identify vulnerable civilians, not target them.
Jesus Christ.
So in theory, Themis could be programmed to target anyone based on any number of parameters.
Exactly. That's the way Cass thinks. Genius, but twisted. We have to stop this. And I know how. We delete the Life Score data, and Themis is done.
For fuck's sake. All right. Done.
Yes, we'll have the award ceremony another time. Get out now. This may be entertaining. I've intercepted an audio transmission from Nigel Cass.
No, no more excuses. This is my city, and I will not have DedSec ruin my plans for it. Themis was poised to change London, the world. And this group of... And Hamish fucking Balaji? I want them all! They made you all look like fools! They walked calmly into the White Tower, and no one, not one of you, stopped them with all our vaunted security measures. So do any of you have anything to say? Nothing. Well, everyone, and I mean everyone, in the organization will be re-vetted immediately. Someone help them, that's certain, and we will root them out. This time, we will get them all.
Well,
oops, sorry, Ian.
That's about done it. Cass is gonna steam about this for a while. No more Life Score, no more Themis. You did it.
It was a joint effort. We couldn't have done it without your help. We're far from finished with Cass, though, if you feel like collaborating more.
Not much of a joiner, fam, considering how my days at Albion ended. But I'll be keeping watch on them and Cass. Maybe feed you lots of intel.
And there's still the question of Zero Day. Remember them? Completely gutted DedSec 1.0.
Cass had a hand in that purge, Bagley, and in the bombings. So we'll gladly accept any help you can give us, Hamish. Cheers.
In the last adventure of Detective Bagley and his occasionally helpful human sidekicks, we discovered that a billionaire tech mogul and a war profiteer both had secret plots to exploit human suffering and murder thousands. A shocking twist, I know. Speaking of the people we most suspect, Mary Kelly's slave trade is bound to be any day now, and we also just received a distress signal from a coffee shop of all places. Maybe the Wi-Fi's down or something.
Is that relevant, Bagley?
Yes, obviously there's more to it than that, but I knew I had to make a joke or you'd just tune it out. I've marked both leads on your optic.
All right. Aiden, where'd you go? Aiden, there you are. All right, we're gonna wrap it up there because it's almost 10 o'clock. Thanks for tuning in and joining me as I continue my way through this game. Yeah. Excuse me. So next time we will dig on deeper through this game. Reminder that the next time will not be next week, but will, however, be in a couple of weeks' time. It'll be in December. Because I'm taking the next 2 weeks off, which are the last 2 weeks of November, I'm taking them off for holiday reasons.
Excuse me.
Anyway, before we head out, be sure to check out these amazing people up here, which includes Yvonne B, who is in the chat for a bit. I also have a link tree where you can find links to my socials, my Discord, my Throne wish list, my Patreon. And speaking of my Patreon, it's right there, patreon.com/crimsonknight. If you want to support me and help me continue to make content, or even make my help me make my content better, that would be the way to do it. So yeah, there are those that you can absolutely check out.
But anyway,
as you can see, I'm kind of tired. So we're gonna wrap it up there. We'll be back on Friday with a new game entirely because we finished Recore. So yeah. Friday at the usual times. And until then, remember to have empathy, be kind, be safe, love yourselves and love everyone around you, and I will see you all next time. I love you all. Peace out.